Friends, today we're going to take Tinkercad, SimLab, and simulate a swing. So let's get cracking. We're going to start today's tutorial at my website. I have got a page dedicated to Tinkercad. Tons of amazing categories. Below that, the day one favorites, the useful starters, and the Tinkercad essentials. We're going to go even lower, though, and we're going to find the multi-lesson projects. These are great for classrooms, but they're also just fun to learn. And we're going to visit the Tinkercad playground. These are the tutorials. Today we're going to talk about the sweet swing. I'll just scroll down a little bit and show you some of the fantastic ones that were created while I was teaching. Once again, this one is about the sweet swing set. The tutorial is less than 10 minutes, and when you're done, this is what you built. And now I have bounced to Tinkercad so you can see it in real life. Once again, it'll take you 10 minutes to build that. It turns out pretty slick. And since I built it, Tinkercad has added SimLab. This lets us interact with what we build. Now there are a few things we've got here: tracers, sliders, the axle, and the pivot. Now if you think about a swing, it needs an axle for the swing to work on. So we're going to set an axle right here. If we shift select these two, we want to do L for align, making the seat the boss so that we're sure we've got it centered. And then you can just eyeball the post to make sure it's centered. We also want to make sure these are all adjustable. Notice I grabbed them all and they move with the arrow keys, which is good. If you accidentally grouped them, that would be a problem. Now we can click on this part and we're going to take it and we're going to connect this one right here. And we're going to connect the other one to the swing set. When we enter SimLab, we need to click on the swing set and we need to make it so it's static. Notice it turns blue, that way it won't move. These all will move. As a matter of fact, when we hit play, you can see those fall. That's not a problem. We'll fix that in a minute. What I want to show you right now is that we can throw things at our swing and we can make it spin. That's pretty fun, but we're going to make it even cooler. Let's go back to the 3D design and we're going to repeat this process for the other two swings. I'm going to click on it, do Control D. I'm going to use Shift Nudge to get it close to the right spot. Then we can simply grab the part and connect it to the swing and the set. I'm going to do Control D again. It nudges a little too far, so I'm going to just Shift Nudge to get it back close to that edge. And then I'm going to connect it to the swing and the set. Let's quickly test to make sure we did it right. Now when we enter and hit play, they all hang. And if we shoot at them, they all swing. So that's pretty cool, but it gets better. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to make something that pushes these. The first way I want you to push them is with a cube. We're going to go back to basic shapes. We're going to set the cube out here. We are going to make it thinner in both directions. And we're going to keep the height because this runs into the swing set really nice. I'm going to just move it 40 or 50 away. And then I do want to line it up. So I'm going to grab these two, choose L for align, and I want to make the swing the boss and make it centered. We're going to go back to SimLab. We're going to grab an awesome one called the slider, and we're going to set it right on that cube. We want the cube to be attached, and we want the swing set, which cannot move, to be attached. We're going to change it to a positional motor. If we look at the limits for this shape, you can see that negative 100 is going to go past a long ways. We don't need this limit to be as far. We can have it just go to that spot. Now we're going to put some interactions on this. If we hit the number 1, I want this thing to change position. It's only going to change when I press it, and I want it to change in this direction, all the way to the max. When I hit number 2, I want it to change position, and I want it to come all the way back past where it was. Friends, now we can go back to SimLab, and when we hit play, if you tap the number 1, bang, it swings the swing. If you tap number 2, it goes back the other way. You have just made an interactive swing set. How cool is that? Now let's have a little more fun with this. We're going to go back to the main menu and let's do it a different way. We are going to go to the creatures and characters. Pick one of the characters that you want to push the swing. I'm going to pick this lady right here. I'm going to shift squeeze so that she's a little smaller because I want her to be able to push through there. I'm going to line it up just like we did a minute ago. Select those two, L for align. And of course, she needs to be aligned with this. Now we want to reuse this slider. Control D, shift nudge to move it over. And then we're going to set up, and then we can set up the interactions once again, connecting her to the swing and connecting it to her. Right now, she would be connected to the same numbers. I want to edit that, and I'm going to clear them. You can just click and clear, and then I'm going to give her interactions attached to 3 and 4. Once again, 3 is going to change position, and I want it to move this way as far as it'll go. I should have stopped where it fit, and we'll fix that in just a second. And then number 4, I want it to change position, and I want to go back as far as it'll go that way. Let's return to SimLab, and let's give it a test. Once again, that is the geometry snapping. Hit play. There's number 1, and here's number 3. Uh-oh, she's not moving. 4 works, but 3 does not. I'm going to hit pause, reset, and let's see what I did on my number 3. Right now it says change position by 0 units. That is obviously a problem. I wanted to change all the way out here, and what happened was I went to the red. I wanted to be in the 100 range. Bingo. Now it's going to function. Let's hit play, and here's number 3. Bingo. Not only is she making it swing, it's doing the loop-de-loop. Course 4 sends it back and flips it the other way. All right, so that's a ton of fun, but I've got one more option. Let's go to this one right here. Once again, make sure we've got it connected to the swing and the set. And then for the axle connector, we're going to make it a stepper motor. We are going to leave these settings alone, and we're just going to interactions. Of course, this will be on number 5. And for our options, we're going to change the position. Now check this out. I can move this, and it brings the swing back. Right there, let's say 60 is my maximum number, and it's only going to be when I press it. And then here's what's really cool. When we hit number 6, we are going to disengage the motor. That makes it so that it falls. Once again, let's return to SimLab. Let's hit play. I'll start it again with number 1, number 3, and you're ready for this. Here comes number 5. It goes up, and when I hit 6, bingo, it gently swings. How cool is that? So a quick wrap up. Once again, I want to say thanks so much to Elizabeth for the question. I love how SimLab makes these things interactive. It's a great way for you to learn about mechanisms and also how to control your computer with some keyboard controls. Also, if you have not used SimLab a ton, I do have an awesome playlist. You can find it with the bit.ly up above or checking in the cards. Finally, friends, I want to thank everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget, there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, make sure you pay attention to the members-only post. Also, a massive shout-out to everybody that supports me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. We have passed 300 members. It is a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions, gain skills, post designs. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you like, hype, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.